So when we talk about IT Act, how do we start about it? So we all are composed, right? We know that there is something called information security. We know there is something called viruses, ransomware. We have got all sort of, you know, technical jargons, phishing, wishing, smishing, evolving every day. But nobody knows the main thing. And the main thing is to be compliant with the law. If you're compliant with the law, you're compliant with major things. I want to ignite your brains to make you understand that how much investment has to be done in learning, especially when it is IT Act, especially when you're working in the information security world. Of course, certifications do matter. It won't matter, but yes, law will matter. Okay? And if you don't, they will beat you to the battle. I will ensure. Okay, by the end of the session, you will understand it is the important thing which has been long ignored. We are 19th year today post its existence, and very few people really know its value. Now, when I say IT Act, I knew this. So now, the very first thing, these are the most important thing, the very first line. What is IT Act? It is composed of 13 chapters, okay, and roughly 90 sections. Not roughly, to be precisely 90 sections, okay? So when you're saying you're IT Act compliant, you're reading all these things properly. I've listed all the chapters. End of the session, definitely if you want to be compliant, you'll go back to home, buy one BHAU Act or anything, or the legal draft copy, approved copy is available on the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology site. Officially, you can download it. See which all sections are available and where all you are not compatible or not complied or not even thought about it. I will tell you, almost 90% of the sections written over here, you should be complying with, you should be upholding, and then after concentrating and moving on to the other certification standards and make those policy and procedures drafted in and around this. Then after, I'll tell you, you have literally Indianized and protected everything in the interest of IT Act, and you are IT Act compliant. Now, why should you do it? Can anybody tell me why we want this IT Act compliance? First question before that, do we really need this to be compliant? You say yes. How many says yes? Anis, your inputs. Will matter. Yeah, it is mandatory because you belong to the telecom regulation, and of course I think so. You are the first people we approach. I used to approach, and my people still approach you guys, knocking, asking favors, asking you to deliver information, but then you say please comply with so and so thing, right? And if you don't, you say it's a deaf ear. We are not listening to this. We are not sharing anything, because they have to not only uphold IT Act, but they also have to uphold the constitutional rights of the individual. At the same time, they have to be at par compliant with their own regulatories. So they have got one regulation more. So as he said, banking sector, they have got RBI. So when they say IT Act compliant, of course, they have got banker's book to be complied with. They have to got some simple commerce principle to be complied with. They also have to be, if they're using ISO as their major thing, IT support system or IT as their major tool, they have to be compliant with the standards of the international right, because they are dealing with those kind of things. Because if they are SWIFT compliant, et cetera, they have to have PCI DSS, they have to have your ISO 27000. And if it is outsourced, again, I think so, ISO 23000 or something. For third party. Yeah. So these are the typical ISO segments where they have to be compliant. But since they are serving in the law within this geographical boundary, they also have to be compliant with this. So majorly, if you see, these are the preliminary section. This is all about definition, all about the act. Second section is about digital signature. It gives you the in-depth information about what digital signatures are, and if you're going to use it, What are the pros and cons, everything, etc., has been given in the section 3. Electronic governance, any governance by the means of electronic media, you're going to use it, bring it, under what law frame are you supposed to perform, what all your responsibilities are, how you need to do it. Everything is defined from Section 4 to Section 10. Attribution, acknowledgement, and dispatch of any kind of electronic records, Section 11 to 13. These are the most things. Because if I take all the section, read out all the section, I don't think so Gaurav will allow me that much of time. We will have to take separate session and we will have to take an official workshop for at least a week, because it is not just throwing on your head. There will be questions equally coming up. Your own institute, own organization where you're working, you will be coming up with a precise question that how does this affect me? How do I frame myself under this these sections and how do I protect it? Okay, protect it means comply with. Now, securing electronic records and securing digital signatures, etc., they are two different things. Okay, a lot of things, if you see today's world, everything is electronic. Your WhatsApp message, no matter how important communications, they are traveling in the electronic media. Okay, you call it social media, you call it any other thing, you call it precisely WhatsApp, FB, your messenger, SMS, but they are traveling in the electronic media. So what kind of electronic records are you maintaining in your organization? Okay, are they protected by the digital signatures? If yes, then the earlier two sections, you have to understand that, understand this, and draft. So then the regulation of the certifying authority, of course, certifying authorities are the authorities who issue the digital signatures to you for the purpose you have to define. There are classes clearly defined, etc. What are their roles? How do they function, etc.? Everything is given over here. From section 17 to section 34, it's a lengthier section. But if you're dealing with those kind of thing, issuing, or you intend to be are one of the promoters for the digital section signatures, etc., you have to understand the sections very well. Digital signature certificates, where it is used, for what it is used, what are the responsibilities, how it is issued, how it is promoted, etc., everything under section 35 to 39. Duties of subscriber, when you are subscribing for digital signatures, when it was drafted, when IT Act was drafted, e-commerce was in mind. So maximum sections were given for e-governance. Okay, during those times, somebody, whoever drafted it, whoever supported the draft, gave them the idea, like, yes, digital signature is the in thing. But I'll tell you, even today, normal auditing, we don't use our digital signatures in practice. Okay, we use digital signatures bare limited, and that is, I think so, income tax filing. And that too, we don't have it. It is with our CAs. Correct me. The first violation for ourselves, which we need to comply, is our digital signatures should be in our custody, not with the CA's custody. If he or she, whoever is handling our accounts, need to file the income tax, please bring the balance sheet. I'll put my dongle. I'll put my password. Please sign it. Take it. Get in your custody. Bye-bye. Being yourself compliant. Simple. We are casual. Oh, sorry. I offended by saying Indians are casual. We believe in too much of blind faith. Oh, vishwasi kya agar andvishwas na. विश्वास भी भला कोई लिख के टटोल के डालता है अंधों की तरह डालो और अंधे बने घूमो महाभारत वैसे रच गया फिर भी हम लोग अंधे बने राइट बेसिक कंप्लायंट राइट सो आई डोंट नो द यंग जनरेशन डिजिटल सिग्नेचर आप लोग कैसे कब यूज करोगे लेकिन जितने भी अर्निंग मेंबर्स है सबके पास डिजिटल सिग्नेचर है साइन करना जरूरी है और मेरे ख्याल से काफी सारे लोग करते भी नहीं है काफी लोग जो करते हैं सीए के ऊपर पूरा कल को उन्होंने कुछ नहीं करना है आपके नाम पे एक डिक्लेरेशन करना है डॉक्यूमेंट साइन करके प्रॉपर्टी जब्त कर लिया आप नॉक करते रह जाओगे कानून को कानून सीधा बता देगा सॉरी बॉस आपने आईटी एक्ट में देखा है डिजिटल लिस्ट आपका जो ड्यूटीज ऑफ सब्सक्राइबर नॉन ट्रांसफरेबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट है आपने दिया ही कैसे दिया है तो भुगतो गेटिंग इट Can anybody tell me the recent case in last 6 months? Actually, one woman is literally trying hard. She lost her 25,000 rupees and the bank has shut it off. We are not responsible. Right. Okay. ATM card. She gave it to her husband during her pregnancy. He went to the ATM, swiped it, asked for the money. Something went wrong, some glitch. Money didn't come out. Money got deducted. Records got updated. Money didn't come out. They followed up with the banks. Even the bank where they were having their account, even the bank from where they tried to remove the money. They're still fighting the case. But as per the bankers, ATM is a non-transferable thing. Even your husband is not allowed to use it. It comes under the identity theft. So they say, since you are not the person, you're not liable to compensate. So you have to understand, I gave you one silly case. So there's another case. Okay, bank is done. I come to the telephone side. Lot of people give KYC. How do you give KYC? Do you know the real method of giving a KYC? Because it's a physical document or some electronic document for, you know, letting the other person know that I am still alive. I am the same person. I am complied. So please keep my services on. Okay. So like with telephone sector, I don't think so. You have been given any, I think so. You do KYC only once or only when they lose their something. And that is the time you are, you know, complying with it. But bank, I think so, every 2 years. Earlier it was 5 years, 3 years, then now 2 years. Okay, every 2 years you guys are doing KYC. KYC, re-KYC. And it continues every 2 years to prove that yes, Vikas Naik, now after 2 years, he is looking like this. He still carries the same card. Last time he gave a PAN card, now the Aadhaar card, etc., etc., etc. But it is not the same. That's the reason maximum fraud happening over here. It doesn't mean it is not happening over there. It is happening, but relevantly, it is lesser on that side, but more on this side. If you see, it is indirect. Some statistics have spoken more than 26-30% of the prepaid subscribers are all, you know, impersonated. All the case of identity theft. Nobody even knows. Do you know any of the government agency issuing you your identity, be it Aadhaar, beat your PAN card, beat any card? Have they bought in any infrastructure or a framework where you put your card number and you come to know in this entire country where all this card has been used? And where you could take an initiative and say, boss, I know about these three. I don't know about the other things. Sign off. When we are talking about that, then we are talking about IT Act compliant at the governance side also. It's a mechanism. It is a failover mechanism which has to be done in a circle, which has to be done like plan, do, PDCA cycle, and it has to continue. Getting it? So IT Act compliance is, lot of people think, acha, crime section padh lena, hum log ye daire mein nahi aana chahiye, khatam. Maximum. I mean, every organization, if you see, when they're talking about IT compliance, they don't even talk about IT compliance. But what do they cover is awareness about the crime sections. Don't do this. Don't do that. Don't share your password. This, that, etc. A little bit of 43 section compliance. And that's it. People think, oh, we have created awareness. We have created posters. We are following the legacy system. We have heard some couple of lectures, some extra input. Okay, I will go to my organization, put another poster. Run another PPT, run another training program. Okay, we are IT compliant. No. IT compliance means how much of information in your organization is under the scope of any of these defined over here. How are you protecting it if things goes wrong? How are you making it available for the police to get the things to the justice side? And if you're compromised or not followed any of this in any given line, you're not IT compliant. It's just as simple as that. Okay. So then this is the interesting part, penalties and adjudication. Anything goes wrong with the record while preserving it, etc., etc., or misuse of it, misrepresentation out of it. A civil side of compensation has been defined over here that you can literally put to the principal secretary IT, put up your case, and the justice will be done. At the same time, if you have lost money, you will be compensated with a proper evaluation. Then there are cyber regulation, appellate tribunal, section 48 to 64, which we are yet to see and witness in this country. There are certain court proceedings, but not on these lines. But yes, with the regulators, this both the things are clearly available. Appellate authority and tribunal authorities are clearly mentioned by TRA and RBI, and they are managing it also very well. Okay, to my belief, very well. Anish would add up how well. Okay, offenses, any section, any crime section, any type of crime. For example, you are an IT company. I'm short of 5 more minutes. Okay. Any section, like for example, you're an IT company, you're developing a software or mere a website, somebody is stealing away it. Okay. So there are sections available like section 65 where a source code theft comes into the picture. Evaluation and audit has to be done before you file this case. If there is any copyright thing, that has to be brought into the picture. Okay. So everything needs to be evolved and see whether if something goes wrong with your organization with the source code, yes, there is a criminal proceeding and sections available. Okay, identity theft and impersonation, which is an abandoned, I think so. That is the reason GDPR is coming into the picture. We are also talking about, you know, general data privacy and all the things, which even in India today, we are very, very, very casual. Be it bank, be it them, be it we ourselves, more than them, you ask yourself, KYC chahiye. Xerox nikala, ye kiya. Xerox nikal do, kisse Xerox nikala, uske paas koi copy hai kya, aapne dekha nahi. Sign kahan kiya, side corner pe kiya. Kyun? Bank wale bolte hai, jiska Xerox liya, uske upar kiya to allowed nahi hai. Matlab, wo lenge nahi, humare ko mana kar dete hai. Chahiye kyun? Why do you need a copy? Okay, if you got a copy, what do you do of that copy? Getting it? So, if you say today, maximum things are on WhatsApp, we click a photograph, WhatsApp pe PAN card sent, click a photograph, WhatsApp pe passport sent, everything is leaked by we ourselves without knowing which other application we have given the same rights and who is stealing away. And then they are saying, "Arey, maine to isi bande ko ye part diya tha, yaar, usi ne kiya hoga." Okay, that is your option, but getting it? So what kind of data to be shared on the digital world? There has to be a drawing of line. There has to be an understanding given by yourself. If you read it very well, if you have some debate or you attend some sessions like this, we could throw some sense. And then after, there is network service providers not to be liable in certain cases of section 79. It has been clearly taken, given some immunity, and miscellaneous section 80 and above till 90 has been drafted. There are certain sections for the police. There are certain sections for the state government. How to govern all these things if in case there are no provisions done under this act. So how the state government or the central government or the regulatory agency will be functional on that particular issue. Okay. So when you talk about IT Act compliance, you have to know which area you're serving, how much of that area comes under this area, which sections are directly relevant to you, which sections are indirectly relevant to you, and you have to comply with it. Because if in case something goes wrong and police come knocking or the court asks for some records, if you don't provide those records, what penalization or what imposition can come against you? Okay, I think so. Thanks for your patience. Yes, I have kept you nervous, I believe, but that is my job. Okay, thanks for everything. Yeah, I'm done with the lecture.